your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, and this is He Say, She Say.
Yo, 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 man, you know exactly what it is, dog. It's He Say, She Say, man. It's your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, holding it down from 6 miles to the mile high. I got CoCo J in the building. What's happening, baby?
What's going on?
Ain't nothing going on, man. Shit, I'm going to need you to turn it up a little bit, though, because it's almost New Year, so you got to be excited about that. Don't forget, man, if you're on eblockradio.com right now, make sure you follow us on social media. Hit us up on Twitter and Instagram. All right, so make sure you hit up CoCo J at Hey, It's CoCo J. That's on Instagram and Twitter. And, of course, myself, Hood Howard Stern, man. Make sure you check us out there. And also on our replays on Tuesdays at www.NewOrleansTalkNetwork.com. All right, so we out here everywhere. You know what I'm saying? You need to be there, but you ain't never there, but we everywhere. But you know what it is, man. It's almost New Year, so we're going to talk a little bit about that in a minute and just a whole bunch of other random stuff. So also don't forget, if you're on eblockradio.com, you can hit us up at 760-283-4647 and join in on the random conversation. So look, it's been about a week. CoCo J, what's been popping with you, baby?
Not much. Celebrated Christmas. So that was good. We went over to my aunt Yvonne's house with her son and her daughter-in-law and her family, her daughter-in-law family, and a couple of my sisters was over there and cousins. So it was nice. We had a good time. She cooked. The food was real good. So that was cool. What else? Celebrating my son Ryan's birthday. He turned 15 on the 28th. So,
all right,
shout out to
him. Okay, happy birthday.
Right. But other than that, that's about it, doing the Zumba classes and stuff like that. And just ready for 2017 to come on in.
Yeah, I guess so. You didn't sound real excited about Christmas, so all you mentioned was dinner. So I guess Christmas wasn't shit, huh?
It was good, the kids. They had a good Christmas. I said we enjoyed ourselves. I enjoyed myself. So everybody was happy, so that was good.
Okay, that's what's up. Yeah. Also, I mean, I guess this is a good time to go ahead and give a shout out to your cousin for her birthday, man. So shout out to Nene, what we used to call 300. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to 300. Happy birthday.
Yeah, shout out to Nene. Happy birthday. They're actually doing something tonight, but I wasn't for sure if I was gonna be able to go or not. So it don't look like I'm going anyway. I done washed my hair all up and everything, so. I'm chilling.
Go down with the website.
Yeah, whatever. But yeah, I'm gonna chill, but I hope they have a good time. I know they will.
That's what's up.
Hey, yeah,
look,
that's about it.
Since the last time we was on air, though, the Mary Fitness joint happened. So how did it go?
It turned out good, actually. A lot of people showed up. So that was good. We had a good time, all three classes. We did all three classes, which was step, boot camp, and Zumba. And I did all three classes, of course, I taught the Zumba class, but I also did, I also attended the step class and the boot camp class. So it was I was packed.
Right.
Okay. But it was well worth it. And, you know, we had, food trays and veggie trays and, you know, waters and snacks and stuff like that. So it was good. It was nice.
Okay, that's what's up. I know we had this conversation off air, but just for the listeners, I would tell them, like, which one you thought was the toughest one, though, out of all three?
No, I would have to say boot camp. Because boot camp, to me, boot camp is just really focusing on you stretching and working those muscles, get the muscles moving, and you got to stand in a certain position for a certain amount of time and stuff. So you can definitely, and I say it's hard because you can definitely feel it while you're doing it. So, definitely boot camp. But I did step for the first time when we were, boot camp was by Bear. We did the Bear session. Step was by Reba. I had fun doing it. I had never did the step class. I said I was going to start going. I want to do that. That's fun. And then Zumba, which is the one I taught, was fun. But yeah, it was cool. I had a good time talking to people I never met. Just kicking it. We did a raffle. So it was a few people that won gifts.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it was cool. I enjoyed myself and everybody else that been enjoyed themselves. So it was well worth it.
That's what's up. So you'll be back this Saturday and then Tuesdays and Thursdays after that. So make sure you give out the information on how people can get down with the Zumba with you.
Yeah, we'll be back. I'll be doing the Zumba class tomorrow from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. at UFIT 2 Fitness Club. And that address is 16915 Livernois Avenue, Detroit, Michigan. And that's once again from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. For all the other classes, go to the website at www.NicoleJackson.Zumba. Almost forgot.
Right.
Yeah, and also you can follow me on Facebook too, CoCo Flow by Nicole Jackson.
All right, that's what's up. That's what. So you excited about the new year, man? You think a lot of people go like really be trying to get their workout on?
You know what? That's how it always starts out to be. Some people stick with it, some people don't. But you know, that's what every New Year's resolution, I believe. Some people make New Year's resolutions, some stick to them. Whether it's being, getting healthy as far as into, getting into fitness or whatever.
Right.
You may stick with it for a minute, and then you may fall off. But it happens. As long as you get back up and try it all over again, just don't wait for a whole year to pass to do so. That's
right. As a fitness instructor, though, how you what you think you got to do to try to keep people, like, interested the whole year? Like, what you think you got to do different? I mean, because I think everybody struggles with it.
I don't know. You just got to keep them motivated. And you're probably motivated by, every time you do a class or something, like, raffle, maybe giveaways, maybe have themes every now and then for the class to where, the 70s, you dress up like a 70s. Like a little wig or something you can work out in, though. You know what I'm saying? I mean, something like that. And that's another thing that the whole UFIT 2 fitness club is going to end up doing eventually. Every month we want to have something like we have for the Merry Fitness Party. We want to come up with a theme every month to get people out to come try out the classes.
We're
working on that. Yeah, so we're working on that. And just keep them motivated. And because it's very easy to get discouraged when it comes to getting fit, working out, being healthy, eating healthy. You got to make it a habit. You know what I'm saying? So once you make it a habit, then it becomes part of your routine. And once it becomes part of your routine, then you're good to go.
That's true. I dig that. Hey, real quick, though, not to keep harping on this, but I mean, as a fitness instructor, like, what keeps you motivated, though?
What keeps me motivated? I don't know. Just to keep other people motivated, I guess. That's what keeps me motivated.
Yeah.
Like, just, I'm getting to an age to where I need to not only, I'm a little person, but which means, being healthy doesn't mean necessarily losing weight. Being healthy is living a healthy life, a lifestyle, having a healthy lifestyle, eating right, working out, getting your heart rate up and going, and just get your bones moving and stuff. That's the main goal right there, is being healthy. A lot of people are going to lose weight. Okay, that's going to happen as soon as you come to the conclusion, okay, I just want to be healthy, and everything else will follow, so. And I think just helping other people get it going and keep their motivation going and stuff. So I think that's my motivation, helping other people.
Yeah. Okay, I can dig that. So what else been going on other than that? That's been your week?
Pretty much. That's been my week. Yeah.
Yeah,
the kids out on vacation still, so.
Right, and you'd be ready for them to go back in a minute.
It's all good right now. Cause they don't really bother me. They be in their own little world. They getting old. Nah, they don't want to be bothered with me no way. So,
yeah, I guess you're right.
So it's all good. But yeah, the kids out. So I'm just chilling with the kids and stuff.
What's going on with you, Howard Stern? Same old, man. Not nothing too major, you know what I'm saying? Spent Christmas working, actually. So, shout out to the plantation. Spent Christmas working and 1,000 miles away from everybody who's important. So, but it was cool, though. You know, it was all good. Thanks to Coco J for Skyping me on Christmas and letting me feel like I was there for just a moment. So, Christmas was cool, though. You know what I'm saying? It's Christmas. When you old, you know what I'm saying? I guess it really ain't nothing. So, I don't really have much to talk about as far as Christmas goes. But a little bit, you know, it was a little bit weird, though, of course, because it's the first Christmas without my mom. Even though last year I missed Christmas with her anyway because I wasn't there. So I guess really it's not the first Christmas without her because I wasn't there, but I did at least get to talk to her. This week, though, nothing really major going on, just trying to get geared up for 2017. Just did the show yesterday, of course, E-Block Radio. Make sure you check out the replay at www.eblockradio.com. Also, too, since last week also, it is something that did happen. We did add a new podcast to the podcast network, so shout out to the Two Uncool Podcast. Make sure you check that out on Tuesdays at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Shout out to the Two Uncool Podcast. Man, it's a flyer podcast. They already was doing their thing, and they were generous enough to share their content with us on eblockradio.com. You can catch the replays at eblockradio.com as well. All right. But outside of that, man, that's really about it. You know, still working on some new projects to come out next year. Writing projects, of course. So just been kind of focusing on that. And, you know, gearing up for the new year, you know, whatever that means. But that's really about it. Don't forget, though, too, if you're on eblockradio.com right now, you can hit us up, 760-283-4647. We're not talking about nothing in particular, just some real random stuff. So if you want to call in and say something random, maybe about what happened during your holiday or what you got going on for the new year, you know, that kind of thing. We're just going to go off into some random talk right now. Now,
We're talking about relationships, random relationship stuff.
Yeah, I mean,
you can talk about
relationship over the holidays. It's not a real topic though. It's not a topic.
No. I'm just saying we are talking about just random relationship things and relationship resolutions and stuff, right?
Yeah. So what do you want to start at? So this holiday, I know last week we talked about how soon you should bring a mate home for Christmas. So just randomly, I want to use this as a topic then. Now, in the event that I use this scenario because you got older boys who at that age who they can really start bringing home company for Christmas basically. And this is my question to you. This is just a random question. You know, anybody can answer, of course, but we just got to talk about it a little bit.
We starting already?
Yeah, we're going to jump off into it unless you want to talk about something else.
Nah, I told you that was all on you, so obviously you ain't had nothing to talk about. So, okay, I'm ready.
No, I mean, I had the thing we talked about yesterday, but I know you didn't want to do that on your show, so I left that alone.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to talk about. But I didn't think it was a good idea. I mean, we can.
No.
Why? I just want to know.
But you
had a comment yesterday, though, so.
That was yesterday on a totally different show. Today is different, so I'm over that now. So it's all good.
But you disrespect my show, but... But you're
no,
say
I'm
it,
not
you?
Disrespecting your show. I'm just saying, I'm over it now, so it's all good. That's how it was yesterday's topic.
I thought it'd be something interesting to bring up, though. So you want to leave that at that? All right, well, look, before we get off into the relationship stuff, though, I did want to mention this, though. I know a couple weeks ago, we was having a conversation about this is totally off the subject. This is just random like news at the beginning, but we was talking about the grandmother who got charged and everything for the kid shooting another kid with a gun. And just randomly I looked at some statistics, you know, and for whatever reason last year it was a lot of accidental shootings, like more than the year prior.
I was trying to tell you.
What do you think is contributing to that, though? And they wasn't.
Go ahead. No, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, and it wasn't it's not an abundance of incidents in a certain group either. So it's not like a lot of black kids killing each other. It's kind of even across. Like, so it's not segregated to a certain demographic either. So that was a little strange too, to be honest. Because I kind of thought that it would kind of pinpoint to a certain demographic, but it kind of don't. So like
you're only pertaining to as far as the ones that happened last year, 2016, right?
Yeah.
So it was a lot that happened in 2016, though.
No, that's what I'm saying. I'm talking about in comparison. This year in comparison to last year is a lot more.
Oh, okay. I think people just being very careless with their weapons, with their guns. Very careless. And, they had an idea in their head, like, they know better and stuff like that. But we're still talking about kids. Kids pay attention. Little kids pay attention. The 3-year-old that shot the 5-year-old or something like that found their, they were with their grandma and granddad. And they was watching him. I'm not sure if it was a boy or a girl. But anyway, the pillow was found under the bed. I mean, the gun was found under the pillow.
Right.
Of course, and that's where they found the little kid found the gun. And that's, that's how it happened. But it's just, I don't know. They let their guard down when you have I think they let their guard down too much when they have a weapon at home. And that's why they don't, another reason why they don't lock it up like they should, because like I said,
right,
they have this idea in their head that kids know better. They know not to touch a gun. They know not to, touch my gun or whatever, because they probably have threatened them a few times or something like that. If they ever do, this is what's going to happen. But
right,
you can never, ever be too careful when it comes to locking up your gun. When it comes to you having a weapon, you can never ever be too careful. Lock it up. I don't give a shit what. I don't care if your bedroom door is closed and you told those kids not to enter that bedroom. Lock it up and put it somewhere high up on the shelf. Somewhere high to where no one can get a hold to it but you. And it's they don't. Unfortunately, that's not what they've been doing. So
right,
it's just real sad. Huh?
No, go ahead.
No, I was just saying, it's just real sad that the kids, as far as in 2016, it's just real sad that these kids have lost their lives because the owner of that gun is not careful. They have become so careless when it comes to securing their weapons like that. And that's sad that somebody's life got to be taken. And then you realize, come on now.
Right.
Yeah, it's just real sad. It's all bad. Just like the 18-year-old now recently, I believe the most recent one that's in Michigan, what happened in Detroit, actually, where the 18-year-old shot a 16-year-old brother.
Right.
He found a gun. He was pointing there playing with it or something. And he's being charged for his murder, for manslaughter.
Because he 18?
I'm not sure of that. I guess so. But I don't have all the details on that story as far as whose gun it was and where was it at and all that kind of stuff. I don't know, but I know it happened. That gun was found somewhere in a home. And now another 16-year-old boy's life is gone because they got a hold of it, or his brother got a hold of it. Yes, should he know better? Yes. But that's the way of thinking now. They think all kids should know better. They know not to touch my gun. Yeah, okay. Kids be so obsessed with guns nowadays. Too obsessed with guns. You gotta be more careful. You gotta take more. You have to be more responsible when you have a weapon in the house. What were you gonna say?
No, I definitely agree. And also, too, I was gonna say, I know people been being careless, but also I think what's contributing to it too is just not just the carelessness, but the people who actually have access to guns. For whatever reason, I think we like under under the impression, because what's going on with politics and everything, that in a minute they gonna tell you you can't have no gun. So now, like, everybody trying to get one, like they going out of style and shit. And I think that's what's adding to the problem, though. Because a lot of people...
Why, because everybody's trying to get one?
Yeah, everybody trying to get one. So even those who aren't necessarily aware of how to store or even handle a gun are purchasing guns. You know what I'm saying?
Well, when you have kids, I mean, yeah, I agree with you at some point, but it's like when you have other people in your home, you should be more cautious as far as how to store that gun. Because I have kids in my home. I would be very, if I was to go out to buy a weapon, I would be very cautious as far as how I keep this gun hidden, or how I put it up or lock it up or whatever. Because I would be worried that my kids would be finding it. I mean, everybody wants a gun because things just happen. It's terrible out here. That's understandable. Right. But if you don't have one, you have to be more responsible for it. That's just like you having a kid. You know you about to have this kid. You know you got to take care of this kid, right?
Right.
So you have to take care of the gun because you have a kid in your home. As well with the gun. So
I agree.
You just have to be more responsible. They started to realize that. I'm sure that we've been hearing this for a long time as far as how these kids are getting a hold of these guns, shooting one another, killing one another, by accident. Though I'm not talking about intentional shooting.
Yeah,
I'm talking about by accident because they're fighting these guns. And of course, kids are going to be infatuated by guns. So some kids are infatuated by guns and just want to hold it, just look at it, hold it, or whatever.
Right.
And so it seems like we should be more aware of that and take more, be more aware of how to conceal it. It seems like when you purchase a gun, it should be mandatory that you take a class. I'm just saying.
It is.
It is?
Well, when you get a CCW, it is.
When you get a CCW,
it's mandatory to have a class.
It's mandatory, right? So, what if you just wanted to go purchase a gun at the gun shop? You haven't had the CCW for that.
You don't have to have a CCW, but you do have to have to get some kind of clearance. But that doesn't require a class. That's what I'm saying. That should be
mandatory on the safety. As soon as you go in there and want to purchase, first you have to take a mandatory class for the safety, as far as safety of a gun, to put it up in, how to put it up in your home for safety something like that. That should be mandatory.
Yeah. Now, all of that's covered when you get a CCW, but you don't necessarily need a CCW to purchase a gun, though. So I guess that's where the gray area is.
Right. So they need to hurry to fix that gray area. Because it's happening too many times now.
I guess the reality of it is that I'm guessing that it's not cost effective.
They need to make it cost effective.
I mean, it's the truth, though.
And I'm sure it is the truth. But they need to find a way around it. Just like they find a way to get these roads fixed. They take extra taxes out or add some to something for whatever. They got to figure out a way for this to happen. Because it needs done. Because obviously, I'm not going to say obviously, because some people should just know better. It's just common sense to a certain degree. Come on now. You would think so, right? But then maybe they need to be reminded. Sometimes common sense got to be reminded of, like, and that's where the class come in at.
Right. Now, would you necessarily pay extra on your taxes if you wasn't a gun owner, though?
You know what? I don't know. That was just, I was just spitting some stuff out. I don't know. I don't know if I would rather. I don't know. If it was just to save some lives, yeah, I don't think I would have a problem with it. If it was to know that a life would be saved because some people need to know the safety, you know, the safetyness of our cars, how you put up a, like a gun up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I would have a problem with it. I don't think I would.
Now think about that for a moment though.
Think about that though.
And I say think about that for a moment because even though we're talking about two different things, this is the basis of the argument for people who don't like Obamacare. They don't want to pay extra on taxes for something that could eventually help save somebody's life. This is basically the same thing, right?
Yeah, pretty much it is.
People
not gonna agree. Some people will. Some people will jump on a bandwagon, and some people won't.
Right.
I think I'm one of those people that will jump on that bandwagon. Yeah.
I'm
just saying.
Yeah, I was just curious. Also, too, man, not to switch gears though, because we gonna get all political, and I know you're scared of politics. Shout out to Princess Leia. And her mama. What's their names though? What's their real names? I can't ever get their
Carrie Fisher, the one that played Princess Leia, and her her mom is Debbie Reynolds.
Okay. Yeah,
Debbie
both
Reynolds.
Passed away.
Yeah.
The first one passed away a couple weeks ago, and then the mom, what, last week or a few days ago?
Well, you know what? Princess Leia, it hasn't been 2 weeks since Carrie passed. It's been about a week, and then I think her mom died like 2 days later. After she passed.
Oh, that's
so,
all?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. So, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, shout out to them, man. Also, too, you know who else passed away, though? Like, I don't know if a lot of people noticed it, but, God, what's his name? John Glenn, right? The astronaut that went to Mars, went to the moon. He passed away. A couple days ago.
When he passed
away? Maybe about three days ago.
I didn't know that.
For some reason, it wasn't like major news. It kind of slipped under. I don't know how that happened. Because I think that's kind of major though, right?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, so yeah, he passed away too. I think it's two other people. I think it's two other people that was on the, you know, that was on the flight, that first flight to the moon, or the only flight, I guess, to the moon. That's still surviving. Now, also too, that's kind of a segue into the new movie that's coming out in January. So, what's the name of it? Hidden Figures. I think that's it don't come out till January. At least I thought. I don't think it come out till January. Yeah. But
I'm thinking about Fences.
Oh yeah, Fences came out
with
on Christmas.
I'm thinking about that movie.
Yeah, it's funny though that this movie took so long to be made. And the only reason I say that is because it's information that nobody, well, I guess somebody knew obviously, but that's something we had never taught. Like, had you ever heard that story about three black, I guess they called computers back in the day, like people who did the math for all the NASA research. Like, had you ever heard anything about that before?
No, I never heard about it.
No, and it's weird though that many years passed by and nobody's told this story or, you know, put it into a movie format. That's kind of strange, all right?
Yeah, but I'm glad they finally did. So, yeah, it looks like it's going to be pretty good, pretty interesting.
Yeah. For sure, man. Shout out to Pharrell who partnered up with some people to get that done as well. And I think that's dope, man. And again, I mentioned this yesterday, so if you checked out E-Block Radio yesterday, then I got off on a tangent about this stuff, just about how 2017 is going to have to be, or it's imperative that it is, a point for black folks to unite and try to like make a movement. So I think movies like that are important to kind of get us back in the mind frame, which I think a month after that, maybe around February, a documentary about James Baldwin is supposed to be released as well. So I think stories like that are going to be the fuel to our new movement. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's dope.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Yeah. All right. So we go get off into the random relationship stuff. and relationship resolution, whatever that might mean to you. Don't forget, if you're on eblockradio.com, you can hit us up at 760-283-4647 and hit that number one key, man. Oh, it's your boy. But I want to go back to what I was getting ready to say earlier, though, about the bringing the new boo home for Christmas. So I don't know if you've experienced this yet, but like, so if one of your sons bring home a girl for Christmas or whatever, and if you're not feeling her, like what would you do? You know what I'm saying? Like would you tell him, or would you hope that he figure it out on his own? Like what would you do in that situation?
Well, you know what? It all depends on which son we're talking about. We're talking about my 21-year-old, which is my oldest son.
Okay.
I wouldn't even say anything. I let him figure it out.
Now, what's the difference?
I hope. What you mean?
What's the difference? You say because you're talking about the older one. Like, what's the difference?
Yeah. I mean, some things he just has to figure out on his own and find out the hard way. Sometimes the hard way on his own, because they don't listen to me anyway. Well, most kids his age don't listen to me anyway. I ain't know, and I don't care, but him, he a grown man, he a grown man, and he make his own choices, and he decides. He just got to figure that on his own. I might say something, because I'm always saying something. So of course I know me,
yeah,
I'm going to say something. But
right.
Anyway, but I'm not going to just be like, she not the one for you, blah blah. You know, a mother always knows, but it takes the child a little bit longer to figure it out on his own. A mother always knows when a woman is not right for him. As far as, you know, this don't look like your type, or is it like she got a lot going on, or something like that. It's just a woman thing. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to another woman that your son is involved with, you just kind of get that vibe. And then you might share that information with your son, but you can't be on him like that. He just has to figure some stuff out on his own. Now, as far as with my 15-year-old, Ryan, I don't know. I think I might be like, he will be even more stubborn about it, I know. But I would be more open with him than I would be with my 21-year-old. Just because.
Why? Because he got to take your word for it, because he's a kid still?
No, I'm not saying that he has to take my word for it, but just because he's real clueless. You know what I'm saying? Like.
I mean, at 21, you can still be clueless.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You can still, but at 21, you just kind of got to let them figure out on their own. At 15, I'm like, look, she is not this, she is not that. Or, you know what I'm saying? Just trying to. Just let him make him believe what you said. So
right.
It's a little different, and I think it depends on the age of your son, as far as, you know, if my word matters or not. But at the end of the day, it really don't matter. At the end of the day, but I mean, you hoping, and then seeing, you know, if they're in that right environment, and you know what type of mother you are, a woman you are. Then they kind of know as well. You know what I'm saying? What they want and what they don't want. So that's how they, you know, some people base their women off of. Not saying that they're looking for a mama, but they, you know, they know what they want just based off their environment, their household, and all that. So, but I'm always gonna have something to say if I have something. No, seriously, it can be either good or bad, though. As a mother, it can be something good, it can be something bad. I can say I like her, or I don't like her. You know, why she dressed like that, or something like
that.
Or something like that, or... Yeah, so I'm as a mother, I'm going to always have something to say, whether it's good or bad, and not just... And not to be just on a negative aspect of it, but just... I don't know, it's just a mother's intuition, I guess. That's what I would call it, because you always
want
the best for your kids. Period. Right.
Right. I feel you. What? So what? What do you think? What's the good, or I guess the best? How I want to ask this. Like, what's the qualifications on one that you would get a thumbs up? Like, what's the qualifications? We talking about for a 21-year-old.
Well, this is just my opinion.
Yeah, just your opinion.
My taste might not be his taste, my son's taste, my older son's taste. But I believe if my qualifications for us, if I had to choose a woman for him, it would be somebody who has a good head on her shoulders, who's trying to better herself, and who can motivate him to do better, and just, you know, somebody that's just trying to do better for herself, not no hood rat that
shout out to the hood rats. You can't come to the Jackson household. Shout out to the hood rats.
Getting high all the time and want to drink all the time and want to party all the time and want to hang out with friends all the time. And I'm just saying,
that don't make you a hood rat at 21. That makes you.
No, I didn't put them two together. I said a hood rat or somebody.
Okay.
Okay. So let's get that together. Yeah, just somebody who can help him out as far as stay on the right path because he's seeing her. You know, a woman always gonna show a man. A man don't even know it, but if you talking to a woman that's trying to get herself together, got herself together, or working on getting herself together, that's gonna make you get in shape as well. Get your stuff together, right?
Vice versa.
So definitely, I want somebody like that. And as far as the looks, his looks is his looks. You know, looks to me really don't even matter. So as long as she good at heart,
Are you talking about for your son?
I mean, looks nowadays don't even matter. I'm talking about period. I don't know what you're talking about.
Nothing.
I am. Yeah, nothing. But anyway, that would be my qualification for him finding him a good woman. But you know, at this age. He experimenting, but I hope he don't experiment too much because once you find that person, you know, once you vibe with that person, click with that person, I say stick with it. And then, but you know, if some other reason for other reasons that a person will never truly show their true colors at the beginning of that relation of their relationship.
You
so
know,
sometimes
so?
I kind of. Nah, I don't think nobody does.
Even at 21? At 21, I think you kind of know what you're dealing with. Because they haven't learned how to conceal it yet.
They haven't learned how to what?
They haven't learned how to conceal it yet.
I don't know. You don't think so?
I don't think so. I think at that age, it's raw talent. So they hadn't learned how to hide it yet. They hadn't learned how to be somebody else on the first date yet.
That might be true.
They kind of at that point where like, damn, this is what I do, so yeah, whatever. It ain't till you get older and then you be trying to, you know, you trying to be something for somebody is when you start doing stuff like that. And I think at 21, you ain't thought that far into it yet, so you probably who you are when you on the date.
Yeah, I gotta agree. I agree with you for that.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
man.
That's true.
Yeah. Don't forget, though, if you're on radio.com, you can hit us up 760-283-4647. We're talking about some random relationship stuff. Then we're about to jump into some relationship resolutions at 760-283-4647 and hit that number one key. We'll move on.
Did you hear about Halle Berry?
What happened? Something else happened to Halle Berry?
You know she got married again, but she's getting a divorce now. I just thought I'd throw that in there. I just heard about that.
When did she get married? I don't even what?
She got married, I think it wasn't even a year. But you know she's been married 1,000 times, right?
Yeah, I know that. I didn't know she got married the last time.
She got married. She's getting a divorce now, so
it can't be every guy. It can't be every dude. It can't be.
Huh?
It can't be every dude, though.
And that's my question. Like, what can be so wrong? Not just to turn to this conversation just to Halle Berry, but what can be? Why do you think a person, whether it's a dude or a woman, why do you think they get married, get divorced, get married, get divorced? Like, you've been in like 4 or 5 different marriages.
Right.
Like, is it a sign saying that you, it's not meant for you to be married, or is it a sign saying like something's wrong with you? You need some deep counseling before you ever get married again, or can you just blame it all on the wives that you married, or all on the men that they married? Like,
right?
What can be really going on?
I think you know what. In the Halle Berry situation, I always say that it's her. Like, I don't know. I just can't believe that it's every dude. But then at the end of the day, though, I think it's a possibility on two things. It could, I mean, this is a far stretch of the imagination, but it could be the person that, it could be the people fault that you dating or marrying. It could be. It could be their fault. It could be their fault, like the other people involved. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Like
the
husband or the wife or whatever. But
right.
The essence of it, though, is still you, though. And what I mean by that is that either you're doing something that's scaring everybody away, or your mentality or your aspirations are forcing you to choose the same type of person over and over. Either way,
right.
It kind of come back to you, though. Either way.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? So it could be that person's fault. Like that, the husbands that she choose could be assholes. They could be the worst men on earth. But it kind of go back to the choices she makes. Yeah.
Clean show.
Huh?
I said yeah. Clean show.
Yeah, I said it could go back to the choices she making. What you talking about?
Don't worry about it.
I didn't say
that. Replay.
What did I say?
None.
I said at the end of the day, it can go back to the choices she's making. I didn't say nothing.
Anyway.
You must have thought I said something else, I guess.
You did. You did say something else. You don't even realize it, but you said it.
I guess not. What did I say?
You said a-hole.
No, I didn't. Oh,
yes,
yeah.
You did, buddy.
I mean, asshole's not a... It's not that serious. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Well, you said asshole, but I just thought I'd let you know. But anyway, I agree as far as her attracting the same type of dudes that she's been having in her life. And that's what anybody, you know, who's in relationships and trying to find something different. But the only way we only attract the same people in our lives is because we're the same person. You know what I'm saying? We want to attract someone different, but we're not willing to change ourselves. So I believe if you change how you are as a person, carry yourself differently, or whatever, then you're going to attract a different kind of man in your life. So that could be the case. And then it could be Halle Berry might just be crazy. She might have a very jealous streak. She might have different personalities, or whatever. I don't know.
That's believable, though. That's believable because it always seemed to me, at least in women. I don't think this is so true for men, but at least in women, it always seemed like the ones that you wouldn't think would be jealous or insecure.
Why wouldn't you think? Because she's pretty?
No.
Why wouldn't you think because
she's famous and she's rich.
What they got to do with her not being jealous?
No, I said being jealous and insecure.
What situation? You shouldn't be jealous.
What situation could you be jealous of or insecure about when you at the top of your game? Like, I don't get it.
Hey, sometimes I don't mean anything. If you just that jealous person, despite of how much money you have, how good you look, what you got, if you just that jealous person, you just a jealous person. That don't have to come. Any of that don't play a role in that when you're jealous. I'm just saying. To me, I don't think it does. Obviously, it doesn't.
When people say, like, when people talk about, it's like I say, especially women. I just say when people talk about women, they say, dang, I can't understand why she insecure, why she jealous. Like, it don't have nothing to do with their looks. You don't think so?
Nah. the prettiest.
I've heard you say he's jealous and insecure.
Huh?
I've heard you say it before, where you said that oftentimes it be pretty women who are insecure, more insecure than like ones who not really.
But
I've heard you say it before.
Okay, and what I mean by that, you can be the prettiest girl but still be insecure. Not because you don't think you look good. You can be insecure in other places. You can just be looking good as hell, but still insecure in other areas in your life. You know what I'm saying? So that definitely happens all the time. So that's just like, I mean, that's just like you just said she a very good actor, no actor. She's pretty and got money.
Wait a second. I said she was a top rated game. I never said she was a good actor.
Oh, okay. Well, she's a no. I said a no. Okay, no. I'm gonna replace that with a known actor. She's a very known actor. Right, she's pretty, and she has money. So that's just like, what about that? I mean, that's kind of just like, you know, that's just kind of saying the same category as far as you have money, you look good, known actor, but you're depressed. You still go through depression. You know, like.
Yeah.
That's just the same thing, basically. So it's that don't stop it from happening. I'm just saying it don't stop it from happening because it happens.
Yeah. Well, no, it don't stop it, but you don't find it to be strange, though.
I wouldn't say it's strange because it happens. Why it's strange because they're the one, they're a celebrity and they shouldn't because they have money, because they look good, because they're a known actor. That don't stop it from happening. We don't know. We know all of this. We know we see them on TV. We know they got money. And we know they know because they always on TV. But we don't know what else they got going on in their life other than what they show us on TV. We don't know what happens behind closed doors. So we don't know why they're depressed or what may be going on within their marriages, within a relationship, or whatever. So I'm just
right.
saying.
No, I feel you.
But anyway,
I think it's strange.
I don't think it's strange because it happens with the normal people. Me, I'm normal. It happens with us. It happens with you.
Right, and I understand that. So
why we don't think it's normal because they're a celebrity?
Because this is the only reason I say this. This is the only reason I say this is because, like. Well, I can't even speak for all celebrities, but I'm guessing at some point, once they get to celebrity status, this is something that they had aspired to do in the first place. So,
but
you would think that
Hollywood is a totally different world. Hollywood probably bring on more stress than the average person working a 9-to-5.
Yeah,
I'm just saying, when it gets to that celebrity level. More stress come on because you got to keep it up. You got to deal with this. You got to deal with the media. You got to deal with paparazzi, all that. So it's more stress added on to it. Than the average person working a 9-to-5.
Right.
So, I'm just saying. But anyway.
No, I didn't know though. I honestly didn't even know she had got married again, let alone divorced. So.
Yeah. So you know. Shout out to Halle Berry. She keep it single for a few years.
She got kids, right? She got kids, right?
She do. Yes,
well, one kid.
Yes.
Or... Yeah, and like
I'm not sure how many.
And from what I understand, like she don't even have them though, right?
I don't know. I think the ex-husband got them.
And the only reason I say that is because you and I both know that when a mama don't have the kids, man, it's got to really be something wrong. At least, I don't know, that's my first impression. If they take your kids from the mama, like, it's got to be something going on. Like, a mama who's financially able to take care of kids, like, that makes it even more odd, don't it?
As a mother, I think so. You have to really wonder what's going on if the kids is not with their mother, unless they have some type of agreement. You know, I don't want to take care of them. I just flat out, you know, and they just made that agreement. Okay, yeah. you get the visitation out, and they deal with me.
Right.
Okay. So right. You know, sometimes, you know, I'm not in the celebrity world in Hollywood, but sometimes it may work like that sometimes because they know they're out of state all the time, and a dad probably just not really as busy as she is or he is or whatever. So it may work out better like that sometimes. But if that's not the case, and your kids got, you know, well, taken from you, unfortunately, then something got to be going on.
Right. I mean, yeah, that's the only thing I was saying. It always seemed weird for a woman who got kids who don't have her kids. And that's probably, you know, that's probably stereotypical. You know, I probably shouldn't even look at it that way, but it seemed odd to me, though. Because it's so hard for a man, a single father, to take their kids. Like, it's so hard for them to get custody. And when it happened, it's almost strange. It makes you wonder, like, damn, what is the mama doing? Like, how did that even happen? Unless they older and then... You know, and she was like, hey, you gotta go stay with your daddy, like boys in the hood or something. But, yeah, outside of that, it seems strange. It just is to me. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay. So let's get to the relationship resolutions right quick.
All right, because, yeah, we only got a few minutes left. So if you got relationship resolutions, you can hit us up 760-283-4647. Hit that number one key. But Coco J, it sounds like you got resolutions for your relationships.
Well, I don't personally know. Like, you know me, I don't make New Year's resolutions. But you know, I'm sure it's a few people out there that may have some New Year's resolutions for their marriages, for their relationships that they're currently in. Uh-huh. But I think for the most part, I'm going to say I think in order for a relationship to work, let me say this: I am not a relationship expert. I do not have a degree. As being one, a relationship expert, but this is just my opinion. But as far as I think nowadays, relationships need to be as one. They need to keep the outsiders out. Work on them, whatever issues they having. Let them communicate together. That's another thing. Communication is a big key to a successful relationship. You have to communicate things, bad things, good things. You don't just communicate the good things. You communicate the bad things as well. So that's a key to the relationship. The other one I just said, keep all the outsiders where they belong, outside. And work on y'all, too.
Now, when you say outsiders, what you mean by outsiders?
Like, outsiders, friends, family. Friends and family. Keep it.
Now, how can you say that when you just said that you was going... You gonna be in your son's ear about his woman. How you gonna say both of those?
First of all, my 15-year-old is different. He's 15. My 21-year-old, I might say something, but he definitely ain't gonna come to me about his issues unless it's a serious issue, and that's when I'm gonna get my input. But he's still young. He's 21. He going through the motions of finding what he like and what he don't like. You know what I'm saying? But I'm talking about as a grown woman, as a grown man.
Not a regular grown woman, but a grown woman. I got you.
I ain't talking about no 21-year-old grown man or no 21-year-old grown woman. I'm talking about a 35-year-old grown woman, 35-year-old man, 32-year-old, any age after 30. That's just it. If you are in a serious relationship, been in a relationship for a few years, or in a marriage for a few years, or even for a few months, whatever y'all going through. Communicate, work it out. If y'all can't work it out, then y'all go your separate ways. But don't bring outsiders in.
What about
y'all problems? Counseling is different. That's confidential.
That's an outsider.
We got a counselor. It's still confidential. They take a confidentiality thing. What you call it?
Confidentiality.
Yeah, because you will be surprised. A lot of people don't want to see your relationship take off or be successful. You know what I'm saying? Family, friends, or whatever. So I say communication. If that's not what y'all, if y'all missing that, definitely find that in y'all relationship to make it work. Just y'all got to talk, communication, and then honesty. Y'all got to keep it real with one another. Despite whether you hurt your mate's feelings or whatever, just keep it real and stay out of love, though. You know what I'm saying? And then just be friends. If you can be friends first before you be lovers, before you be a couple. You got to be friends first because you would never want to hurt your friend in no kind of way. So that means if you got that, I would never want to hurt my friend, then you won't never want to hurt your mate. Or, you know, so.
Yeah, I understand.
So that would definitely help out relationships, I believe, in 2017. Communication, honesty, and be friends. And keep out the outside.
you really stuck on that, huh?
I am. I don't like people to know my business. Well, if I'm having issues in my relationship, this is between me and my man. We gonna talk this out. Now, say for example, if I may need some advice, I'm still not gonna say what's going on in my relationship. I'm probably asking for advice, and they probably just, you know, well, she must be.
Well, hold on, wait a minute. How do you ask for advice without saying nothing?
Without really going into detail, it can easily be done. You don't have to go in detail. You know what I'm saying? If you ask an older person for advice about something, but I don't do that. I really do that. I have to say as I become, you know, after my 30s, I don't do that. I just work it out. And some things I just ask, you know, I just take it to God. I'm going to be honest with you. So what would be yours?
That's what's up, man. We only got like less than a minute left, so I'm going to try to squeeze it in there. So relationship resolutions for me, man, like you said, communication is important, but also the type of communication and how to communicate is also important. But the most important thing, I think, for any relationship is to be happy. Whatever that means to you. So whatever you got to do to make yourself and your mate happy inside that relationship, then you got to do it. Simple as that. I can't really get more specific than that. You feel me?
Yep.
Especially with only 15 seconds left.
I feel you.
On that note, man, we about to keep it pushing, man. We got to get up out of here. I want to thank everybody who checked us out today. What's happening?
I said, yeah, Happy New Year.
Oh, yeah, yeah, it is. Happy New Year, right, so we won't be back until 2017.
Right.
Yeah. So you gotta celebrate. Yeah, that's why we're doing relationship resolutions, because it's over with.
Y'all, we gotta bring it in, y'all. We gotta bring it in good. We gotta bring it in right. Meaning, be safe out there in the 2000. Why are you bringing it in 2017? Bring it in safe.
Right.
Bring it in with a bell and not a bang.
Bring it in alive. How about that? Just bring it in alive. That's what we gonna do. Just bring it in, not dead.
Right.
Hey, on that note, man, we up out of here. I want to thank everybody who checked us out today, of course, on eblockradio.com. Make sure you check out the replays also on eblockradio.com. But until next year, man, it's your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, holding it down from 6 Mile to the Mile High.
And it's your girl, CoCo J. Have a safe and blessed Happy New Year. Peace out, y'all.
Peace out, y'all.